Welcome back. Of course, we know it's still February, just another day, which means it's officially still American Heart Month, and it's designed to raise awareness about heart health and prevent heart disease. And a dear forever friend of mine, childhood friend Donnie Peterson, is a heart survivor and here to share your story. Thank you for being with us today. And when
just before the end of the month.
I know, we got to get your story in because I think it's such a powerful story. You look so healthy. You are young. You're vibrant. You work out. You run. And you had no idea you were like a ticking time bomb.
Well, it's amazing how you look back and you say, boy, am I getting old? Am I just getting out of shape? And I think anybody in their early to mid-50s, late 40s, I think, I've lost a couple of friends that maybe didn't listen to their body the way they probably should have. And I was very lucky in that I had friends that are cardiologists, mm-hmm. and I took action. And
you were starting to slow down, you noticed, like,
sure.
Am I just out of shape? Or?
Well, any time my heart rate got elevated, I'd get short of breath and a little tight in my chest, and so I went to my personal doctor, Michael Tremonia, and he ordered an EKG, and I got that, and it was bad. And so I had a heart catheterization procedure, mm-hmm. by Dr. Sabi down at Mercy Medical Center, and it came back, and it was bad. And
so you said they were doing the procedure and kind of started backing up, and you're like, what's going on?
Well, yeah, I was like, well, I'll just get a stent or an angioplasty, yeah. get some relief. And he said, no, you've got 90% blockage in one and 80% blockage in two others and 70% blockage in two others. And we're going to have surgery tomorrow.
Unbelievable.
And I look at my wife and I said, where are my pants?
You're like, I want to get out of here.
I got to get out of here, man. I don't want to look like the crazy person walking out of the hospital in a gown, you know?
Because it wasn't what you planned for.
Oh,
you thought you were going in for a
totally
quick,
not
easy
even,
procedure.
You'd not on the radar. Not on the radar at all.
So you're 12 weeks post-op.
Post, right. And I feel great. I mean, it's a matter of diligence and keeping a good attitude. And I have a lot of support. My wife, Christine,
she's the best.
She's my primary caregiver for the last 26 years.
She pushed me to get into TV. Thank you, Christine.
And you know, I have a team. It's great.
Were you on cholesterol medication, blood pressure? Were they watching any of those?
I was on nothing. I was on nothing. And so they say I'm going into surgery, and I'm in complete, you know, shock and denial, and just wanted to get out. And my mother-in-law was in the room, and she's talking to my doctor and the guy who did the heart catheterization. And then the surgeon was in, mm-hmm. there also, Dr. Twill, who was great also. And she says, let me tell you a story. And she said, you know, a year and a half ago, my husband, my father-in-law, was out working in the yard and came in. He's all sweaty and looked terrible, and she said, Len, you look horrible. I think we need to go to the hospital. And he said, I feel bad. Let me go rinse off and we'll, mm-hmm. go. And she said 10 minutes later, he was dead, and he had had a massive heart attack. And she said, I'm not gonna let that happen again. So, you know, you just gotta. The funny thing is, she says, I'm not gonna let that happen again. And the surgeon, Dr. Twill, looks at me and he goes, so, you're staying.
Because you were still thinking.
I said, yeah, I'm going to stay.
And well, because you're busy. You're running a radio station.
Yeah.
You have two teenage sons. You just think, I think we all feel that, well, I don't have time for this.
Right.
This is a major procedure. So you had, at the end of the day, the end of the surgery.
Five, quintuple bypass.
Five bypass. Yep. You were in the hospital.
It's a miracle. It's a crazy. And I guess the message is, if anybody out there can't do what they were able to do 2 years ago, go get yourself checked out.
What's your 6 months ago, right?
Guys, I'm getting old. I'm getting out of shape. It's just part of the aging process. And I think that if you just listen to your body, that'll tell the tale. And you just got to be active and proactive and get, mm-hmm. it done.
You got lucky.
I was lucky.
And you got a great team around you.
Great, yeah, it's great. And, you know.
And a good message, Donnie.
And Steph is an alumni of WDJQ and WDPN.
That's where I got my start. Yeah,
at Mount Union.
Radio station.
It's great.
Yep, we'll be there Monday.
I'm looking forward to it.
All right, he's the best. And thank you for sharing your story with us.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Incredible.